to my eyes, eyes, eyes. And I'm tired of it, tired of it. I don't wanna wonder where she been.
Where she at?
My name is Edlin, aka Cowboy Fit Me. You watching Hawk's Eye View. Let's get it, baby.
Welcome back to the worldwide leader of all things Hanahan. I'm Molly Ducker. It's Friday, August 23rd, and you're watching Hawk's Eye View. As you may have realized, the school district has been a lot more strict on phones in the classroom this school year. For more on that, here is HEV's Sawyer Brunel.
Thanks, Molly. As I'm sure we all know, there's a new cell phone policy here at Hanahan.
So back in June of 2024, the state of South Carolina decided that they were going to basically ban or outlaw cell phones in public schools. The only time that cell phones are allowed are before school, after school, and during lunch.
I don't like it. It's like, it's annoying because what if we need our phones for like an emergency or something, but like now it's over there sitting on a caddy and we can't text nobody.
When I was in the classroom, students would play on the cell phones, play games, music. So I think it's just a way of teachers to be able to utilize their instructional time a lot better and keep the students engaged.
I think that the cell phone policy is going to make them spend more time on their class and not worry so much about TikTok and what Jenny Lou in another class thinks.
I think the cell phone rule is kind of dumb, in my opinion, because I just want to listen to music while I do my classwork. You know, it helps me focus and concentrate.
I think it's a good idea, but after we get our work done, I think they should, like, give it back. So, like, it's like a reward kind of thing.
Need to do a riot to get this stuff changed.
Thanks to everyone that answered. Now back to Molly in the studio.
Thanks, Sawyer. And make sure y'all put y'all's phones up. You freshmen may not be able to have your phones at school, but you can start campaigning for your STUCO position. Campaigns for STUCO freshman leadership will begin on Monday. Voting for these positions will take place next Thursday during SOAR after the AGV freshman election special. The results will be announced that Friday during Hawk's Eye View. Please see Ms. Gant if you have any questions. Be sure you freshmen start getting your campaigns ready for Monday. But will the weather cooperate for your campaign? Good thing we have ATV's newest weather expert, Stefan Slaughter, to find out.
Thanks, Molly. I'm back with the first weather forecast of the new school year, and things are looking up. I'm here on the football field where the Hanahan Hawks are hosting their first game of the season. You guys are probably wondering, what's the weather looking like for the big game? Let's get into it.
By kickoff, there will be a 30% chance of showers and thunderstorms. It will be mostly cloudy with a low of around 71 degrees, so it will be nice and comfortable if we dodge the rain. Going into Saturday and Sunday, not much changes. It will be partly sunny with a high of around 85 degrees and a 50% chance of thunderstorms on Saturday. On Sunday, there is a 20% chance of thunderstorms with a high of 86 and a low near 72.
And that's a wrap on your HEV weekend weather forecast. I'm Stefan Slaughter. Now back to Molly in the studio.
Thanks, Steph. It would be great news if we got a lot of sun here this weekend. Speaking of news, here are some for you seniors. 12th graders, be on the lookout for an email from Miss Murray about all senior information for this school year. The email will be sent to your Berkeley County email. Oh, and senior fees will be $120. This fee will cover yearbook costs and the cost for using the Coliseum for graduation. This does not include cap and gown fees, though. Finally, our senior class meeting will be Tuesday, September 24th. It will take place in the auditorium at 10:30. And if you seniors want to be a part of a little something extra this year, listen up. Are you interested in performing in the first theater play of the year? If so, Mr. Roberts will be holding auditions this Monday and Tuesday, August 26th and 27th for the fall one-act play, Escape Room Play. Auditions will be from 4 to 6 p.m. in the auditorium. Feel free to come on either day. And if you were worried about never being in a play before, there is no experience necessary. Please see Mr. Roberts in room 16 if you have any questions.
We're looking for people both to audition to act on stage, as well as to help out backstage with props and with lights and with sound and all those kinds of things. So if you've done a bunch of theater, we'd love to have you. If you've never done anything with theater before, we'd also love to have you. The only thing that I ask and that I'm hoping to see from you is some excitement, some energy, and an open mind.
And from one Roberts to another, Dr. Roberts is holding an interest meeting for the Robotics Club. Want to build the next big robot on campus? There will be a Robotics Club interest meeting in room 106, Dr. Roberts' room, on Wednesday, August 28th, after school. Have you lost anything while on campus here at Hanahan? Well, I have the perfect solution for you. If you have lost anything around school, make sure you check the lost and found in the front office. They have a large collection of items such as water bottles, phones, AirPods, and clothing. So if you've ever lost something, there's a good chance you could find it in the front office in the lost and found. So be sure you go and pick up your missing belongings. Y'all may be missing some items, but don't be missing your spirit at the football games. And to make sure you don't, Stuco has you covered. Here's HEV's own McKenna Hannah with more.
Thanks, Molly. Spirit packs are a new thing Student Council has started this year, so let's go take a look at what they are. Spirit packs are a kit with everything you need to show your spirit and dress up for the theme each week. Here's the one for our game this Friday. Stuco will be selling these during lunches and at the gate for $5 cash only. Now, let's go take a look at their socials. These are all of our class level accounts, as well as the main student body account. Keep your eyes peeled for all future info. If I were you, I would follow all socials to be the first one to know about any updates. That's all I have for you today. Now, back to Molly in the studio.
Thanks, McKenna. As you've heard, Stuco plays a big part in all of our student section themes. But what are you really showing up for? The games, of course. So let's send it over to ATV's newest sports anchor, Ava Crawford, for the latest on all your Hawk sports.
Thanks, Molly. I'm Ava Crawford, and welcome back to HEV Sports. A new school year brings us another season of Hawk football. Kicking off this Friday night, our Hawks take on the Iron Horses from Philip Simmons right here at Wiley Knight Stadium at 7:30 p.m. Make sure to dress up in all of your dress code appropriate pool-themed outfits to start off the season right. With more on the season opener, let's send it over to HEV's very own Lauren First. Lauren?
Thanks, Ava. As most of you know, football season is starting back up. Our Hawks start off with a home opener right here at Wiley Knight Stadium tonight at 7:30. And even though it is only game one, it is still a big game.
In the opening, it's the first game. Our mentality every week is to go 1-0. So you definitely want to win this one. But again, with it being a crosstown rival, it means a lot to our community and our kids.
The importance of the home opener is, as Coach Turner be saying, you got to bring the juice. If we bring the juice, unstoppable. If the crowd bringing the juice, unstoppable. So, we unstoppable.
In this game is to just spread the ball out, toss it to our receivers, and block on the perimeter. If we block on the perimeter, since they put a lot of their players in the box, and we should be winning this game.
Remember, tickets are now $10 online or at the gate. Kickoff is at 7:30 and the theme is School Appropriate Hawks by the Pool. And for now, back to Ava and the HEV Sports Center.
Thanks, Lauren. Let's transition from the field to the court. On Tuesday, our girls tennis team went up against the Knights at Stratford. The Lady Hawks number one singles player, senior Lorelei Rumpel, scores the last point to win her set with a final score of 6-3. Next up, the Lady Hawks number two singles player, senior Camden Lawson, hits a dime to finish up her set with a final score of 6-0. Great job, ladies. With a long match, our girls came out on top, finishing with a final score of 7-0, winning overall against the Knights. Now, let's take a look at what our boys volleyball team has been up to. Starting off, our boys took on Cathedral Academy and Low Country Wildcats in a tri-match on Monday. Our boys came out with the win with a final score of 2-0. Going into their next match against Cathedral Academy, they won 2-0 in that one as well. Good job, boys. Moving on to Tuesday, our boys volleyball team moved along to play against Lucy Beckham and Sakosti. Unfortunately, our boys fell short against both teams. So that's all that happened this week. Now, let's take a look on some upcoming games on our schedule. Let's start off with the big home opener tonight versus Philip Simmons. Remember to wear your school-appropriate pool attire for the student section theme. Kickoff is at 7:30. The girls volleyball team has an away tournament coming up this weekend. They also are away on Wednesday, the 28th, to play a tri-match against West Ashley and Berkeley. As for boys volleyball, they're at the Iron Horse Invitational on Saturday, the 24th, and on the 26th, our boys go up against the Wando Warriors. Finishing off the week, the Hawk volleyball team plays Cathedral Academy at home at 6 p.m. Now on to our cross country team. They have their first meet Saturday, the 24th, at the Pinewood Invitational starting at 8 a.m. Good luck. Finally, our Hawk swim team has their first meet on Tuesday, August 27th at Cane Bay High School at 6 p.m. Good luck to all of our athletes competing.
And make sure you stay up to date on all of our Hawk sports, visiting bcsdschools.net and finding all your scores, rosters, and schedules under HHS Athletics. That's all the sports we have for you this week, Hawks. Now let's send it back to Molly in the studio.
Thanks, Ava. For our last segment, let's bring back a fan favorite from last year. James Stewart brings us this year's first episode of Jambalaya.
What's up, Hanahan Hawks? It's your boy, Jambalaya. We're in downtown right now. We're going to be interviewing the people of Charleston or the new people of Charleston. So let's get to it. What's your name?
Sean.
Sean, you from Charleston?
I'm from Massachusetts.
Where are you from?
New Orleans.
Bruce McMillan.
Bruce McMillan. You from Charleston? Have you seen the pineapple fountain yet?
Been here since 1979, originally from Georgia.
Pineapple fountain, I don't think so. Yeah.
Well, then they have a watermelon one too.
Oh, really?
Yes, and a passion fruit one.
I haven't been there yet either.
You see those stairs over there?
Yes.
Blackbeard, the guy who was captured and brought here, he climbed up those stairs, right?
George Bush did 9/11.
Yes.
And danced with Nicki Minaj. Did you know, actually over here in this park, there was a pastor that came over here and he blessed the land.
Nicki Minaj.
Oh, really?
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, like there's like videos of it and stuff. It's insane, yeah.
It was.
Nicki Minaj.
And that black beard is what you said?
I don't know his name. I think his last name was Hines. I think it was. It was like Pastor Hines. But yeah, y'all can look him up.
Yeah. Ain't he old?
I mean, he's like, like 400. Can y'all point me in the direction where the birdies are, like the females?
That way,
all right. Hey. I mean, do you come down here often?
Often to buy her stuff, yeah.
Oh, y'all dating?
Yeah.
Oh, how long?
A year and 7 months.
He retracts them.
So wait, over that way?
We're going this way, so call me that way.
This way, okay. Then yeah, I'm probably gonna walk this way. Where's the ring at? I say for the real ring, she get like emerald or something.
Emerald.
Cause you already got her a diamond. Look, show the camera.
Yeah, I'll have to go mine some emeralds in my Minecraft world, you know?
Oh, you're gonna propose on Minecraft?
Yeah.
Is that how y'all met?
I like that idea.
With her pink sheeps.
I just put you on. She said she likes that idea. I think I'm gonna call it wraps here. I'm sweating. I just wanna go home and eat a bowl of jambalaya. I'll see y'all next week, Hanahan. It was fun.
Thanks, Jimbo. Well, that's all we have for you this week, Hawks. From all of us here at Hawks Eye View, I'm Molly Ducker, and we hope to see you tonight at the stadium for the big football game against the Iron Horses. Have an amazing weekend, everyone.
We're the Media Tech Boys. Of course, we know our favorite teachers.
Connor, you and your Media Tech boys, get out of here!
We're the Media Tech boys. Of course we walk around with the camera for no reason.
We're the Media Tech boys. Of course we're going to interrupt your lunch for no reason. What's your favorite color?